Sluga et Dionino Politas, pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy church and for all who entered with faith, reverence, and fear, O God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Most Reverend Metropolitan William, for our Roman Bishop Kurt, for the Venerable Presbytery, the Diaconate in Christ, and on the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our government and for all service of our country, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city, community, and for the faithful in kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by sea or land, for the sick, the suffering, the captive, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we be delivered from all affliction, breath, and need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Protect us, save us, have mercy on us, and preserve us, O God, by your grace.
Lord,
commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, the Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Lord our God, mighty beyond description, glorious about all understanding, mercy without limits, loving us all with discretion. Look with compassion on us in this holy church, O Master, and shower us, and those who pray with us the riches of your tender mercy. For to your Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is no glory, honor, and worship, now and ever and forever.
Oh,
attentive. And we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Thank you.
Let us be attentive. Peace be to all. Wisdom be attentive. Be attentive.
My brothers and sisters, when Christ our life appears, then you shall appear with him in glory. Put to death whatever in your nature is rooted in earth, fornication, uncleanliness, passion, evil desires, and that lust which is idolatry. These are the sins which provoke God's wrath. Your own conduct was once of this sort, when these sins were your very life. You must put that aside now, all the anger and quick temper, the malice, the insults, the foul language. Stop lying to one another. What you have done is put aside your old self with its past deeds and put on a new man, one who grows in knowledge as he is formed anew in the image of his Creator. There is no Greek or Jew here, circumcised or uncircumcised, foreigner, Scythian, slave, or free man. Rather, Christ is everything in all of you.
Peace be to you, reader. Wisdom be attentive. Let us stand and listen to the Holy Gospel. Peace be to all.
And to your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Be attentive. The Lord told this parable. A man was giving a large dinner, and he invited many. At dinner time, he sent his servant to say to those invited, "Come along, everything is ready now." But they began to excuse themselves, one at all. The first one said to the servant, "I have bought some land and must go out and inspect it. Please excuse me." Another said, "I have bought five yoke of oxen and I am going out to test them. Please excuse me. A third said, I am newly married, and so I cannot attend. The servant, returning, reported all this to his master. The master of the house grew angry, and at the account, he said to the servant, go out quickly into the streets and alleys of the town and bring in the poor and the crippled, the blind and the lame. The servant reported, after some time, your orders have been carried out, my lord, and there is still room. The master then said to the servant, go out into the highways and along the hedgerows and force them to come in. I want my house to be full, but I tell you that no one of those invited shall taste it, a morsel of my dinner. For many are called, but few are chosen. Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to God.
Slava Isusu Christu.
Slava.
Dear brothers and sisters, we continue to celebrate Sunday by Sunday. Today is 28th Sunday, and we call the Sunday of the forefathers of our holy ancestors. Yesterday, during the Vespers, at the end, when we finished with the doxology, we was singing, come, O lovers of the feast, let us sing a hymn of praise to the assembly of the forefathers, Adam, the father of the human race, Enoch, Noé, Melchizedek, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Let us all so honor those who came after the law, Moses, Aaron, Joshua, Samuel, and David, together with the Isaiah, Ezekiel, and Jeremiah, Daniel, and the 12 minor prophets, likewise Elijah, Elisha, and all the others, also Zechariah, the Baptist, and all those who preached Christ, the life and the resurrection of our race. How nice, beautiful. That's why I'm saying it's important our tradition, liturgical cycle that we have during the year. Every Saturday, Vespers, they are preparing us for to celebrate the next day, like Sunday. Mostly we are we can hear about the holy resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, because each Sunday is the center of the holy, pointed on the holy resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. But like today, we more we go forward, more we are closer to the feast of Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this Sunday, Holy Mother Church is putting in front of us, our eyes, the example. The people in the Old Testament, why? Because they were simple like we are now. They hear the voice of God, they catch it, they put it in practice, and they follow. So we hear our Lord is saying us this parable, that one man giving a large dinner and invited many. That's like our Lord, our God, is inviting each of us for dinner, for big feast, for eternal, happy, beautiful life. And we have to believe. And my job as a priest is to, I must use all my talent to tell you that God is inviting each of us to be happy. And sometimes we are like this three men. We are saying, Lord, sorry, I get married, I cannot come today in church. Or I bought the land and I need to go and see. And so many, many excuses. And Lord could be angry if he is inviting and we are saying, Lord, sorry, not today. Maybe next Sunday, maybe next year, maybe I don't know when. And we are looking on this, our forefathers, they was just following what God was telling them. Simple example. Abraham, he left everything. When Lord asked him, bring me in sacrifice your only begotten son, without reflecting, because he trusted completely in God. Let's say if we have invitation to go for some banquet or birthday, how we are going? We are preparing, yes? We put the best vestments what we have, we try to bring some gifts, and we go because we are invited. Now, Lord is inviting each of us to be happy. What we need to do? Believe. Number one, to have strong faith like our forefathers had. And never, never try to have dubium in our life. God is with us. We are going to celebrate this. And we were singing during the feast days. We have to remember, God loves us because he sent his only begotten son, our Lord Jesus Christ, which the birthday we are preparing to celebrate. So what we need to bring with us for this invitation? I think, Lord, we just want to stay in front of that place together with the shepherds, with the angels, and bring to you our hearts, our soul. And bring maybe full bag of our sins and saying, Lord, that's only that I can bring to you. I mean, we can cut this bag in holy confession. You remember at the beginning when we start to make this preparation, Lent or Advent, we are going in two directions. We are trying to do the good deals and to clean inside, throughout everything what is not nice in front of our Lord, to go in the holy confession to prepare our soul. That is waiting from us, our Lord. And believe me, I'm telling you with the words of Saint Paul, who was taken in the heaven with the body and soul. He said, the human language is poor to express what God prepared to those who loves him. We have to believe. And remember how many times Lord Jesus Christ teaching and telling to the people when he was in this life between the people, how many times he was saying, blessed those who don't sow but believe. We are in these conditions. So we have to believe. Lord, open our minds and souls to accept your holy word, to believe in your good news, that you love us all. You want us to be happy forever and ever. Amen. Let us all say with our own soul, with our whole mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord Almighty God, our fathers, we pray you hear and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray you hear and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our Holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, for our Most Reverend Metropolitan William, for our Bishop Kurt, for those who serve this Holy Church, for our spiritual fathers, and for all our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our government and for all who serve our country.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray, O Lord our God, hear our supplication through your grace. Have mercy on your servants, all our pardoners. Grant all their petitions and pardon all their voluntary and involuntary sins. Accept their supplications and charitable deeds before the throne of your majesty. Safeguard them from every visible and invisible enemy, from every misfortune, distress, and affliction. Spare them from illness and grant them health and long life. Let us all say, Lord, hear and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again. Loving Lord, look down with merciful eyes upon your servants, all our parishioners, and hear the supplication that we have offered up with faith. For you yourself have said, believe that you will receive whatever you ask for in prayer, it will be yours. You also said, ask and you will receive. Because of this unworthy as we are, we trust in your mercy and ask that you be merciful to your servants, all our parishioners, and fulfill their good desires. Keep them in peace, tranquility, and health, and grant them long life. Let us all say, O Lord, hear and graciously have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the people here present to await your great and abundant mercy, for those who show us mercy, and for all Christians of the true faith.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful and loving God, and give glory to your Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Oh,
May the Lord God remember his kingdom, our Holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, our Most Reverend Metropolitan William, our Godly Bishop Kurt, entire priestly, diaconal, and monastic orders, our civil authorities and all service our country, the ever memorable founders, benefactors of the Holy Church, may the Lord God remember all you Christians of the true faith, always, now and ever, and forever. Precious gifts, place it before us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
have mercy. Lord God Almighty, we alone are holy and receive the sacrifice of praise from those who call upon you with their whole heart. Accept also the praise of us sinners, bring us to your holy altar, enable us to offer you gifts and spiritual sacrifices for our sins and for the people's failings. Make us worthy to find favor in your sight, that our sacrifice may be pleasing to you, and then the good spirit of your grace may rest on us, on these gifts here present, and on all your people. Grant this through the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed together with your holy, good, and life creating spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
Peace be to all. Let us love one another, that it one might we may profess.
The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity one in essence, and the divine.
In wisdom, let us be attentive.
Lord of the Father, before all.
us stand right, let us stand here, let us be attentive to all in our for in peace.
Mercy, peace,
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and Father in the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Let us lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord. It is proper and just to sing to you, to bless you, to praise you, to thank you, to worship you every place of your dominion. For you are God ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing, yet ever the same, your only begotten Son, your Holy Spirit. You brought us out of non-existence into being, and again there is up and fallen, and left nothing, and then until you brought us to heaven and gave us your kingdom to come. For all this we thank you, your only begotten Son, your Holy Spirit, for all that we know and that we do not know, for the manifest and imperfect bestowed on us. We also thank you for this liturgy, which you are pleased to accept from our hands. Even though they stand before you thousands of archangels, tens of thousands of angels, cherubim and seraphim, six with many eyes, sorrowing out of their wings. Singing, shouting, crying aloud, and saying the triumphal hymn. Also cry out with this blessed power, saluting our Master, and say, Holy are you and all holy, you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit. Holy are you and all holy, and magnificent is your glory. You so loved your world that you gave your only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him should not perish but have life everlasting. He came and fulfilled the whole divine plan in our behalf on the night he was betrayed, rather when he surrendered himself for the life of the world. He took bread into his holy pure immaculate hands, gave thanks and blessed, sanctified, broke, and gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take it, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the remission of sins. Likewise, he took the chalice after supper, saying, Drink of this, all of you, this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Remember that for the saving of his country, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, the ascension into and the sitting in the right and second coming in glory. Offering you your own from your own, always and everywhere. Moreover, we offer to the Spirit of God the sacrifice, the report, and the creature, send out the Holy Spirit upon us and upon this gift lying before us. And may this bread, the precious body of your Christ, and that which is in the chalice, the precious blood of your Christ, changing them by your Holy Spirit. And for those who partake of them and drink him of the spirit of vigilance, the mission of sin through the Holy Spirit, through this holy kingdom, God. confidence in our condemnation. Gloria for the spiritual sacrifice of those departed in faith. The forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, fathers, martyrs, confessors, saints, and for every just spirit brought to perfection in faith. Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Theotokos and the Virgin Mary. First, Lord, remember our Holy Father Francis, Pope of Rome, our Most Royal Metropolitan William, our Godlord Bishop Kurt, preserve them for your Holy Churches in peace, safety, honor, and health for many years, that they faithfully impart the word of your truth. City in which we dwell, in every city and community, and the faithful we keep them. Remember all those who travel by sea, and let the sick, the suffering, the captive, and grant them salvation. Remember all those who bring offerings and perform good deeds in your holy churches, and also remember the poor and upon all of us, send down your mercies, and grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your most honored and magnificent name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
May the mercy of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Now that we have commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts offered and consecrated, our God, who loves us all, may receive them on his holy, heavenly, and mystical altar as an aroma of spiritual fragrance, and send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
That we be delivered from all affliction, breath, and need, let us pray to the Lord. Protect us, save us, have mercy on us, and preserve us, O God, by your grace.
Lord,
let this whole day be perfect, holy, peace without sin. Let us beseech the Lord. For an angel of peace, a faithful guide and guardian of our souls and bodies, let us beseech the Lord. For the pardon and remission of sins and offenses, let us beseech the Lord. For what is good and beneficial to our souls, and for a peace in the world, let us beseech the Lord. That we may spend the rest of our life in peace and repentance, let us beseech the Lord. For a Christian, painless, unashamed, peaceful end of life, and for a good account before the fierce of judgment seat of Christ, let us beseech the Lord. Asking for unity in the faith and for communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another, and our whole life to Christ our God. Master, who loves us all, we commit our whole life and hope, and we implore, pray, and entreat you, make us worthy to partake with a clear conscience of your heavenly awesome mysteries. From this secret spiritual table, may they bring about the remission of sins, the pardon of transgression, the communion of the Holy Spirit, the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, confidence in you, no judgment or condemnation, And make us worthy, O Master, that we may with confidence without condemnation dare call you Father, God of heaven, and say, the kingdom and the power and the glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
Peace be to all.
And to your spirit.
Bow your heads to the Lord. Give you thanks, O invisible King, for by your immeasurable power you have fashioned all things, and in greatness of your mercy have brought all things out of non-existence into being. Look down from heaven, O Master, upon those who bow their heads to you, for they do not bow to flesh and blood, but to you, the awesome God. Therefore, O Master, make smooth for the good of all the path that lies ahead according to the need of each. Save those who sail, travel those who travel, cure those who are sick, O physician of souls and bodies. Through the grace, the mercy, and the loving kindness of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed together with your holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
O God, be merciful to me, let us be attentive, holy gifts to holy people.
Oh,
Approach with fear, O God, and with faith.
Thank you.
servant of God, then I see him of our precious blood and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Behold, this touch your lips, will take away your iniquities and will cleanse all your sins. Save your people, O God, and bless your inheritance.
We have seen God through the Lord. We have received your heavenly spirit. We have found the true faith, and we worship the divine Trinity. For the Trinity has
blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and forever. Now that we have received the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly life, creating also mysteries of Christ, let us worthy thank the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We thank you, Master Benefactor, our souls, who loves us all, that this day you have made us worthy of your heavenly and immortal mysteries, through the prayers and intercession of the glorious Theotokos of the Virgin Mary, and of all your saints, make straight our path. Confirm us all in fear of you. Guard our life and safeguard our steps. For you are our sanctification, and we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, blessing those who bless you and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Preserve the fullness of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power. And do not forsake us, hope in you. Grant peace to your will, to your churches, to the priests of our God, and to all your people. For all generous giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from you, the Father of lights. And we give glory, thanks, and worship to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. The blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace and loving kindness, always, now and ever and forever.
Amen.
Glory to you, Christ, God our Lord, glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and forever. Amen. Lord, have mercy,
May Christ, our true God, risen from the dead, have mercy on us and save us through the prayers of His most pure Mother and of the Holy, glorious, and through the apostles, our old Father John Christ, Archbishop of Constantinople, Satan, the Patron of the Holy Church, the Holy Four Fathers, whose feast and memory we celebrate today, through the praise of all the saints, for Christ is God and loves us all. The next week program is like usually, Tuesday evening liturgy 6 p.m., Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, 8:30 in the morning, Wednesday in the evening 6 p.m., Moleben to Emmanuel, and Saturday in the evening 6 p.m., Vespers. Sunday like usually, 7:30, Matins, liturgy 8 and 10:30. I wish you all the best. Thank you for coming and praying and celebrating today together. Don't forget coming home that we get each of us invitation for eternal banquet. What we need to do, the Holy Spirit will inspire our insight, and let's be guided by the Holy Spirit. Do good deals, be just good human being like God created you at the beginning, and everything will be okay. We are looking to be in the heavenly kingdom at that banquet forever. Believe me, that's something. We are chosen for this. God bless you all. Grant the Lord to all our parishioners peace, health, and happiness for many blessed years.
Page 147 of Baha'i Rajat Sadhguru.